Sure, but Bakugo's always angry, so he'll never be that popular.
What did you say? I'll kick your ass!
You see?
You know, we basically just met you, so it's kind of telling that we all know your personality is flaming crap mixed with garbage.
There is a lot to like about Boku no Hero. I mean, I made 3 videos about it, and I'm not even close to done with everything that I have to say, but many of the reasons I like the show so much all stem from the foundation it offers with its characters. The foundation to any good anime are characters the viewer can connect to. Without characters being likable in some way, any interesting story just becomes dull, and the greatest production values become nothing more than a spectacle without substance. Even the deep, complex characters don't mean anything if there isn't some reason for the viewer to care about them so they're complexity can be appreciated. And likable characters is something that Boku no Hero nails from the very start. The very first scene establishes Deku as an underdog who wants to do good, making him someone instantly likable. Then through the exposition, Deku talks about how the world isn't fair, but instead of lamenting because of that fact, he instead dedicates himself to working even harder so he can accomplish his goals. The underdog story is one that's easy to get behind because we like seeing characters overcome adversity. The show harnesses the power of an underdog story by presenting this aspect of stories so early on, and is therefore able to get his care about Deku and want to see him succeed. And with this aspect established, from there, they can build the rest of the story. The show also illustrates Deku's personality early on so we get to know him. We see that he is a timid but excitable young man. He cares about those around him and dreams of becoming a hero. He's also stubborn and courageous when there's something that he's really after. These traits are all shown very early on, letting us quickly figure out who Deku is once the initial scene made us care about him, and so we wanted to learn more. Now, some would say that Deku isn't a deep or complex character, and well, they're right. Even as he grows throughout the series, he's never all that interesting of a character, but he is a likable one, and that is what makes him so great. Because of the strong establishment of his character early on, I really wanted to root for him and to see him overcome the challenges that the story throws his way. His tactical mind and his knowledge of all the heroes was really neat because we could see him win his fights not by raw power, but more often than not through outsmarting his opponents. But then his tactical mind also led to some more comical moments with him mumbling when he gets nervous, making him feel more human and relatable. His doubts about if he's worthy of his power also make him really likable because of his humility. A powerful story storytelling tool is to show a humble character succeeding while a proud character is humbled, and they do this wonderfully with Deku, especially in contrast to Bakugo. So all these factors are what make Deku one of my favorite characters in all of anime. But it is far from Deku who the show is able to do right. All Might's larger-than-life personality makes us want to root for him from the very start, and then the truth about him makes him sympathetic, though there is far more to say about All Might than I can do in just a small part of this video. Then there's Bakugo, who's kind of the antagonist for the first few episodes, but his drive to be the best, boisterous personality, and even his arrogance make him someone to root for, especially as he is forcefully humbled by Deku and the other students at UA. He's forced to learn and grow throughout the story, and this makes him great. While he isn't exactly a good person, his strong personality draws the viewer to him despite his flaws, and we want to see more of him. The other UA characters are also able to quickly appeal to the audience. Since there are a lot of characters, they don't really have as much time to build them as they do with Deku, so the show instead starts small, showing a couple of characters at a time and using their powers to make us interested in them in a sort of Rule of Cool type of way. Then in later arcs, the anime is able to highlight them and really show who they are. A good example of this is Todoroki, whose first major appearance was just him showing how powerful he was before he could be fully fleshed out in the sports festival. Then you have a more subtle example with Uraraka, who stopped Deku from tripping and falling at the end of episode 3, which showed us her caring and bubbly personality and formed the connection between her and Deku, which led to the powerful moment in episode 4, where he saved her for the robot, and then she saved him from falling. And then from there, they were able to build up the friendship between Deku and Uraraka throughout the entire show. Her character is one like Deku, where the likability of her personality was clear from the start, and then they were able to propel her character arc with her desire to become stronger during and after the sports festival. Another thing the show does right with its characters is how it gives them moments to shine. In a show with a cast this large, it's easy for the main character to get the focus and for the rest to feel just like background characters that don't matter. But Boku no Hero is able to avoid this issue. While some characters are certainly focused on more than others, they all have their own stories, conflicts, and memorable scenes. Oftentimes during the show, the class is split into small groups and we're able to see each one fight, letting a side character show off their quirk and get some time in the spotlight. This leads to a lot of them getting a crowning moment of awesome by doing something that only they can, like how Sue or Mina are able to use their quirks along with Deku to escape the villains in the USJ arc, or how Sue and Minato are able to use their powers in unique ways during the Calvary battle, or the battle with Minato and Midnight. You know, for a comic relief character, Miyota really did get some great moments. And then there is Dane, who is the perfect type of villain for a story like this, all about optimism and becoming a hero. His hatred of fake heroes and their pursuit of money and fame instead of actually helping the others makes a lot of sense in this world, and his desire to make the world a better place is noble, even if he is misguided in the way he does so. He is really able to contrast the rest of the characters well, and his relatable goals make him a character for the viewer to root for even as he opposes the rest of the heroes. But I think the greatest proof of the connection the characters form with the viewer was during the Calvary battle, where Ito was able to use his overdrive so his team could steal Deku's headband. The reason I say that is because of how much it made me cheer for Ito, showing how much the show made me care for him, because I was glad that he was able to defeat Deku in the moment. And keep in mind, Deku is one of my favorite characters in anime. This proves how much the show is able to get me to root for Ito, and he's far from the only character I get that from. I also want to bring up an issue that I've seen others criticize Boku no Hero for in the first season, and that is a lack of character development. And to be honest, this complaint kind of makes me wonder if some people are just looking for a smart sounding reason to complain. Because the first season is only just the start of an anime that could very well reach over 100 episodes by the end of it, so you wouldn't expect to see a lot of character development in only 13 episodes. But despite that, we actually did get character development. The 2-episode introduction arc had Deku's worldview built up, crushed, and then rebuilt, Bakugo was forcefully humbled, showing that he isn't as strong as he thought, and beginning his character arc, and All Might's passion for being a hero was rekindled by Deku's courage, leading him to put aside his regrets to save Deku and Bakugo. Plus, Bakugo's character arc continued all throughout his battle with Deku in about halfway through season 1, and then has continued all throughout season 2. Plus, during the USJ arc, you had characters learning to overcome their fear with the villains attacking, Minato being the most prominent example. So while the first season did focus more on that foundation for the characters, to say it didn't have character development would just be wrong. And the growth of the characters in season 2, such as Todoroki, and Bakugo, and Nita, have been great, and it makes up for any possible lack of development in season 1. So, that is me fanboying about these characters for a few minutes. But you might have noticed that I glossed over possibly the most remarkable character of all, but don't worry, I will talk more about him next time.